I'm at least back reporting.
So yesterday we talked about athletes who retired. You say let them. So yeah, you say let them live. Once they retire, don't talk about potential fights. Just let them go.
Yeah, because I mean they retire. Most of us retire for because not only of age, because we've done everything that we could do, and there's a process, and the process is at the end of the day, no athlete can do what they've done forever.
That's true.
So if life is not forever, then how can you expect your career to be forever? And I prepared way before the time that I retire that when I'm done, whatever age that will be at the time, I'm done. So we should let retire. I mean, it's good to have fun talk about the present and now, like who would beat who and this era and the era of the 80s, the 90s, and even if you go all the way back to the 70s. But one thing we do know, that boxing will live forever because it's always will be the next champ. And that's why it's a great sport.
So I got to ask you this. Danny Jacobs, Canelo, is that a good fight? Do you like that one?
Danny Jacobs and Canelo.
Because a lot of people feel Danny beat Triple G, or at least...
I mean, the middleweight division is hot again.
Yeah.
And any match that can be matched up and will be matched up, if the promoters, the managers, and of course the fighters is important, want to do a super fight or a fight that matters, then yes. I mean, I think that every division have one or two or three, hopefully, matchups that we can call super fights. Now, I'm not going to say impossible, but rarely you have multi-divisions with multiple numbers of fights that can be called a super fight. We know the month of the calendar year of the super fight dates, and that's May and September. So, right now, Canelo, you can say own that. And fights is going to be made in the division, whether it's Daniel Jacobs or anyone else. It could be Lemieux, it could be this person, it could be that guy.
It's
rematch with Triple G, which I want to see before anything happens. But you, because I don't want no one else to beat him but us. And so it came very, very close. I thought, even though you didn't ask, I had it 7-5 before I even went in the ring. I've spoken to many people. What you think before the rule was read or the scorecards was read. And I was on point. So, boxing is in people's conversation and mainstream understands it. And wherever it comes and however it comes, as long as it's positive, of course, it brings a light on our sport. So, you know, maybe we'll see another fighter taking on a wrestler or MMA or UFC or hockey player or football player or basketball player. Who knows?
That's what Broner tells me. He wants to fight Steph Curry next. If Mayweather can fight McGregor, he wants a basketball player. That's what he told me.
Listen, I don't know how far. I don't want it to turn into a circus, but I think that's unrealistic more than being realistic because, you know, you want to deal with at least a situation where you can say, well, the guy takes karate, he just can't kick in this situation. So he used to combat on a boxing level, so I wouldn't doubt it, but it's hard to swallow the MMA and the UFC saying that, you know, they can't compete with us because they really can't, and it proved it.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSekpak.